Steve.
Hello, Dave.
Steve, how are you doing?
I'm all right. How are you, mate?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you? Look at that beard.
Can you see me all right?
I see you.
Good lad. Dave's new trainer.
Yep.
New confidence. What can fans expect on Saturday that they won't have seen before from Dave Allen?
Well, like I said earlier, I don't think much going to really change. I don't think I'm going to change massively, really. Good, everything a little bit faster, a little bit quicker. It's the confidence. I think I've always had the talent, always had the athletic ability, but I've never had the mindset with it. And I credit Jamie for a lot of that. James gave me a lot of belief. Darren Barker told me in the gym, you can be any heavyweight in the world, David, if you're on the top of your game and you go in there and you do everything correct. And for this fight, you know what? It's not been perfect. Never it is. It was not for Christopher and it won't be for anyone else on the card. But I've never felt as good as this. I've never felt as confident. I've never felt as physically good, mentally in a better place. So I'm over the moon. I'm over the moon with it. I just can't wait for Saturday.
Good man. Last time we spoke, Dave, you said, I promise I'll headline the O2 again.
Yep.
Being serious, mate. Now that it's 4 days out, this must mean an awful lot to you.
Yeah, I think this fight, winning this fight, I think could set me up to headline the O2 again. Gives me a world ranking. I'm blessed to have a massive following. Headline the O2 before. I think being in Lovejoy, it's not about being Lovejoy. This is not about being Christopher Lovejoy. It's about being a number 15 Frank heavyweight with the WBA. That's what this fight is, you know. I'm not overlooking Christopher Lovejoy at all because there's nobody in the world right now that is more wary of him than me. You know, other people will look and say he's no good or whatever else. I'm looking at him thinking, I'm only looking at the positives of him. I don't look at negatives. If I look at the positives, you know, because the negatives, they'll find, I've got the experience now where any negatives, I'll find them in the ring and I'll expose them. But the positives are what I've got to look at. I know what I've got to worry about. So there's no overlooking him, but it's nice to be excited. And I am excited. It's been a long time since I've been excited about boxing. So it's a great feeling. And this week, I'm going to really enjoy it.
Good, man. Last one for me. I interviewed Christopher on Sunday night and asked him for a question. Yeah. And he said, no doubt he's going to knock you out in the second round.
Yeah.
I presume you don't agree. So how do you think the fight's going to go, mate?
Well, if he knocks me out in the second round, I'll be amazed. I think it comes down to experience, you know. I'm sure this fella with another 20, 30 fights as an amateur or a pro, it will be a different proposition altogether, but he's not. So be very interesting, but I don't see any way that this man can beat me because I don't think he's that good.
You want rounds or do you want to knock him out?
I'm not bothering, mate. I'd be very surprised if this man stands up to me as soon as I hit him. I expect it to be over as soon as I hit him, in all honesty.
Good man. Dave, best luck on Saturday, mate. I'll speak to you soon.
Thank you very much, Steve. Cheers, mate.